So I'm here with Mike Mendoza for this episode of The Vote. We're going to be looking at the pandemic, the COVID pandemic, and what the recent developments are. The pubs have opened. Clubs have
barbershops are open.
Barbershops are open. So they had the haircut. It wasn't as bad as what we thought it was in terms of people crowding together spreading the COVID. It was,
yeah,
it was more organised than what I thought it would be.
Yeah, I think most restaurants and bars that are opened are being very, very cautious, as they should be, of course. And they put a lot of measures in place. As you know, the barber shops, they're putting screens up. All those working there are wearing masks or shields of some sort. And I think they're all being very, very cautious, which is it's what they've got to. They want to survive. They want to carry on in business. And I'm sure if you go into a place and they're all on top of each other, you're not going to carry on going there.
Yeah.
Therefore, they've got to be very careful.
Yeah, exactly. I went to a pub in near Shoreham. It did seem organised. It was a bit strange, but... I mean, the beer garden worked pretty well. I mean, we were clearly all far apart, and it wasn't table service. We went up to the bar.
Oh, really? I was surprised.
Yeah. So, but it seemed to work, and there wasn't as many people as I thought there was. The football, they weren't showing the football, so maybe that was the reason why it was a bit emptier. But it was quite pleasant, actually. It was nice to have a pint, I have to say, and with my mum.
Was the atmosphere still there?
Yeah, the atmosphere was there. I mean, I was with my mum anyway, so we were chatting. But, yeah, people were friendly, and... yeah, I mean, I think they were just slowly... They were saying that they were expected to get busier in like 2 or 3 weeks' time when people...
Got used to it.
Get used to it, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So. I mean, I wouldn't go into a pub at the moment, but I'll go in the garden. I mean, I've booked this week to go to a pub, but I've booked a table in the garden there because I know I'm going to be safe there. You've got the fresh air. You're far enough away from people not to have to worry about it. And it's table service. I mean, a lot of pubs now, that's what they're doing. You've got a book or you arrive at the door and you're showing to a table and you've got to have a sort of table service.
Yeah.
Which, again, it's got to be safe that way.
Yeah, we didn't book either. We just turned up there on the day. So that was quite nice. It was similar to what it would have been like anyway.
Yeah.
What about restaurants? Have you booked any restaurants yet?
No. I won't go into a restaurant at the moment. I've got a lot of friends who've got restaurants. They're going to be really annoyed with me. But no, at the moment, I just won't go into an enclosed situation.
Yeah. But you're going to a big on. So how do you think that it's going to work out in the next few weeks? And do you think more and more people are going to come out? I mean, Churchill Square, the shopping area, I was been there 2 or 3 times. It's not been massively busy. It's been fairly busy. I've noticed shops are opening up a bit earlier, like 9 a.m.
Yeah.
9 a.m. onwards. Marks Spencer at 8 a.m. I noticed.
And the council, of course, are now closing off a lot more roads around Brighton.
Yeah.
In fact, I think all the lanes now, all those roads from Middle Street all the way around Ship Street, all going to be closed, I think, from Friday.
Yeah.
And that's to enable social distancing, but it's going to kill anyone who wants to drive into town now. That's completely gone. Whether that's going to bring more people in, I don't think so. I think it's a complete waste of time.